following is a special presentation of WEDU Tampa, St. Petersburg, Sarasota.
Central Avenue Remembered, a salute to our African American heritage, was made possible through the generosity of the Saunders Foundation, a proud supporter of WEDU and PBS.
When you wish for that which is no more, be careful what you're wishing for.
Anything that took place in the black community, 9 times out of 10, it started on Central Avenue.
And who you ask to perform the act of bringing our ancestors back?
It was like a city within a city. It was like it's its own place.
African Americans in that community and thousands of others had developed survival mechanisms which had not only allowed them to survive, but in many cases to triumph.
Because sometimes they wake up wrong and offer screams instead of songs. But today, I'm willing to ignore those ancient ones who were laid down sore, who warned us never to molest the sacred places where they rest. With clarinets and dollophones, with shakerays and chicken bones, I conjure up the memory, majesty, and treachery. I call up names no one has spoken since black people's hearts were broken down on Central Avenue.
Way out on the outskirts of town.
It was located on the outskirts of downtown Tampa in what today is Perry Harvey Senior Park, next to the Interstate Highway interchange known locally as Malfunction Junction. A series of streets that became a city unto themselves for African Americans in Tampa. Central Avenue between Cass and K Streets was to Tampa what Harlem was to New York City. It was a destination, a bustling black business district, and a center of African American music and culture. Jim Crow laws and legal segregation separated whites and blacks, making most businesses off limits for dark-skinned people.
If you lived on Central Avenue or near Central Avenue in that neighborhood in the first half of the 20th century, probably the dominant reality for you was the cradle-to-grave Jim Crow segregation system.
I think that inside the box, we were blessed and we were safe. When we got outside, we had to deal with the world for what it really was, you know, and it wasn't a pretty sight.
The land beneath Perry Harvey Senior Park percolates with black history. It was originally settled by freed slaves in 1865. Some are buried nearby at Oak Lawn Cemetery. The worst part of the surrounding neighborhood was known simply as the Scrubs. It was a place you lived when you had no place better.
It was a rough life. I told my parents that I'm leaving here because we can wind up and all of us can be dead in this little small street I'm living in, you know?
You had outhouses, you had running water, but still it was outside all on the back porch.
It was a dilapidated place, old broken down houses, but the people lived there anyway. They couldn't do no better.
Between 1900 and 1930, the black population in Tampa quadrupled. Prior to 1900, most African-American businesses had been downtown and served white and black customers. But the tightening of Jim Crow laws and segregation increasingly confined black businesses to Central Avenue, where customers were predominantly black. So, enterprising African-Americans created a community of their own as a means to survive and sometimes thrive.
I sing of the Harlem of the South that would have turned Walt Disney out. A wondrous place of open mind that made Ray Charles say, "I'm not blind," and bought a bike and pedaled it too, all over Central Avenue.
By the early 1930s, the Central Avenue community was thriving.
It was not a place to live, but it was a business district. It had a lot of restaurants, two or three bars and grills, and rumored houses, and a hotel.
One of the many black entrepreneurs on Central Avenue was Moses White, operator of several restaurants. The Palm Dinette was a popular spot, but people went out of their way to dine at his best-known eatery, the Cozy Corner.
And that became famous for three things: camaraderie, three hot dogs for a quarter, and the fried chicken.
Cozy Corner had the best chicken and yellow rice, very beautiful desserts. As a matter of fact, they had a lemon meringue cake pie that you can't find no more. It doesn't exist.